sick emails. This is my email. Emails go twice.
Good evening and welcome to the Solon Planning Commission meeting for June 26, 2018. We'd like to start with the Pledge of Allegiance, please.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right, we've got a pretty short agenda, so we will get along and no changes. So we will go ahead and start up with the roll call, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Here.
Mayor Kraus?
Here.
Mr. Mazur?
Here.
Mr. Newberry?
Here.
Mr. Palunas?
Here.
Excellent, thank you. There are no changes to the agenda tonight, so we'll go ahead and move on. This is the time in the meeting where if someone has a comment and they're not a party to the agenda item, but they have a comment on the agenda item, now would be the time they would come up to the podium and give us their name and address and tell us why they're here and what they want to comment on. So these are comments from the audience regarding agenda items. So if anyone, yep, please, come on up there, give us your name and address and tell us why you're here. Thank you. Thanks for coming.
Good evening, commissioners. My name is Eric Sarmiento. I'm an attorney with Cavitch, Familo, and Durkin here on behalf of Dr. and Mrs. Joseph Krall in connection with agenda item one, the variance request for 7112 Navajo Trail. On behalf of the Krawls, we object this variance request for a few reasons, primarily because we believe it is premature. The Heritage Landing Homeowners Association, which I'd also sent an email to, I believe, the clerk of this council about getting approval for the variance request before it is approved or brought to council. So we believe it is premature for that reason. In addition, we received a letter, or Ms. Krall received a letter from the clerk of council on June 16th. The letter was dated June 14th and gave a June 21st deadline to receive any comments. And then June 26th, this meeting being held to bring up any type of objections to the request. So we feel that there's not really an adequate period of notice to think about alternatives or getting approval from the, approval from the Homeowners Association prior to requesting this variance. In addition, I would, in order to avoid repeating what the council may already, or the commission may already know, have the commissioners been provided with a copy of the letter from Attorney Tom Belden of our office?
Yes.
So, thank you. We, to avoid reiterating everything in that letter, we also would just like to refer that and make that part of the record in terms of our other objections and potentially other alternatives if ultimately the variance is granted, that we would like to have the opportunity to work with the Krawls and avoid any sort of major issues in the future with respect to this variance being granted and providing an adequate period of time to explore any alternatives before it moves forward. So unless there are any other questions.
No, but yeah, the letter you're referring to was we received on June 21st at the clerk of council, Solon, stamped, and it was included in all of our packages. Okay. So we actually have that letter too. I actually have two copies of it in here if you need one back, but it's we have two copies of it in there. I guess I've got one question, kinda. You talked about the time frame between the 14th and the 16th and the 26th, right?
The 21st being the deadline for
right.
to provide response.
In your opinion, that's not enough time to form an opinion about what's going on here, to vet it all out?
Not necessarily to form an opinion. That may have already happened, but in terms of trying to work with the neighbors in a friendly sort of fashion to avoid anything happening too quickly or moving too quickly before things can escalate or between the neighbors or before it's not fully explored whether underground utilities or water, cable, television issues will be created or arise. Similarly, runoff issues. The Krawls already have issues with drainage onto their property, and the concern there is that additional concrete as opposed to the landscaping that is present there currently and removal of that landscaping will further exacerbate the flooding and water issues. In addition, I believe the other side of the Navajo Trail property that is requesting the variance does not have a home on it, so we would also like to potentially explore if this variance is approved or if there's an intent to still move forward with it, potentially going on the opposite side away from the Crawls household. Just an opportunity to explore what other alternatives that there might be to avoid any issues with the neighboring properties.
I understand. So that first one was time. The second one, you mentioned something about the homeowners association and their process to, you felt their process was too quick, or I was trying to.
Right, they actually haven't gone through the homeowners association process. There is a reported declaration of easements, covenants, restrictions.
We have an approval.
Are you guys going to read it or give it to them?
We do have an approval.
Okay. Apologize. The last correspondence I had from the homeowners association was that there needed to still be submitted the plans for approval.
But we have, please be advised, this has been approved by the Heritage Landings Association. Please contact me with any questions. Mark Glatley.
Okay. I apologize for that. I was unaware of that approval letter.
No problem whatsoever. Yeah, that's why we're here, to make sure that everybody gets
Thank
it.
Thank you.
It's a copy.
Can we just give them this copy?
Sure.
We're going to give you a copy so you have it?
Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you.
Hey, Mr. Chairman, I would just like to state for the record the type and manner and timing of notices as we typically do, so there's nothing unusual about this with regard to notice. And in fact, any deadline mentioned, I mean, obviously the commission's prepared to take comments up until the time, as you're here today.
Okay.
The time of hearing, so.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And sir, when the applicant does come up, I am gonna ask him about several different contingencies that I would like to look at, having this as my ward. And I represent this ward. I'm going to ask him about several contingencies and about several other questions, and I will ask that of him.
We appreciate that. Thank you. And we understand that there are maybe a couple other driveways in the neighborhood that have been widened, but not to fully extend the width of the entire driveway, but to extend it in such a way that it's narrow at the bottom and wider at the top. Request would be for that to be considered as well. Consideration of the water issue and making sure that any construction that takes place with expanding the driveway, if that is approved, be kept on the property owners who's requesting the variance to this property, and also that there be replacement landscaping to address any flooding issues, and also that any additional waste or garbage that is present on the property currently or as a result of the requested variance be cleaned up and remain in a sightly condition. Appreciate your time, and if there are no other questions.
Any other questions from the, no? Okay. Thank you.
Okay, thank
Appreciate
you.
It.
Thank you.
All right, our next item on our agenda, we are going to deal with some minutes, two sets of minutes we need to deal with.
Chairman, I move approval of the minutes for the May 15th, 2018 Planning Commission meeting as presented.
Second.
We have a motion and a second, and we would like to vote, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Krause?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes.
I'll make a motion to approve the minutes from May 29th.
Second.
We have a motion and 2 seconds. And we'd like to vote, please. Mayor?
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Krause?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes.
All right, thank you. So our first and only agenda item, new, is for 7112 Navajo Trail. The applicant is here. Give us your name and address, please, and tell us why you're here.
Hi, my name is Gennady Fainer. I live at 7112 Navajo Trail. And we'd like to get permit to extend our driveway. Where should I put this?
The square.
Right here. Oh, he has it.
It. Is that good?
Dang it. All right, so show us with your fingers where the existing driveway is, and then show
Here's
us where
the existing driveway, uh-huh. Right here.
Okay.
And we'd like to get an addition on the left-hand side, which is south side of the driveway.
Okay. The addition is 8 feet wide, 24.5, and then it angles out
right.
to the curb.
Yes, basically it's going to be exactly same pattern like every other house in a development, with 3 car garages or 2 car garages. Everybody has same pattern for a driveway. and it was just added to another house, same way, exactly.
Is that the re, I mean, what's the purpose of this?
Oh, the purpose, we have four people live in our house. We already have three cars. And if we leave one car in the driveway, don't even plow our driveway in the wintertime. Next year, my wife gonna start driving, so we're gonna have a fourth car. So that's why we need to open up the driveway, plus, you know, to have access to the garage, plus so they can plow our driveway. Otherwise, we have to shovel it.
Mr. Bentley?
Oh, please, I'm sorry, please.
Oh, sir, good evening, how are you? A question was brought up by the neighbor next door. Is there any way you could move the area of pavement to, when you're looking at the driveway, to the right instead of the left? Is there any way you could do that, or would that not be able to be done?
I don't know. You, first of all, it's gonna change all the pattern. Like, if you look on every house, every driveway, that's why we figure, and plus you got open space there on the left-hand side. Sure. Over there, they got walkway to the house, and it goes right to the house.
Okay, next question. Would you be willing to enter into agreement or contingency to your application if you're keeping the driveway in the same location where it is? And I've received one negative comment, which is the resident who's here tonight, as have the rest of Planning Commission. If you're keeping the driveway in the location where you're proposing it, would you be willing to enter into a contingency where you're going to put in some screening that is agreeable by the planning director and the planning department to screen the neighbor from the driveway, as well as into some type of a contingency, second contingency, that any excess water runoff caused by the additional pavement would be handled on your property? Would you be willing to do that?
What kind of screening are you talking about?
I'm talking about some type of a shrubbery that Mr. Franklin, would you explain?
I mean, it could be something like boxwood or something that maybe that would just obscure the driveway.
Yeah, there's some shrubs on the side. Of, we're not gonna remove them all. We just go up to them.
Right, if there's screening that would remain, then that would be sufficient. I think what the councilman's referring to is some type, if the screening's removed, there'd be some type of evergreen screening, shrubs,
yeah,
or something.
It will be planted. Some, we're planning to plant new shrubs and bushes, whatever, you know.
Yeah.
We don't want to open either.
But you would accept that as a contingency?
Yes.
That you plant shrubbery?
Absolutely.
Upon the recommendation of the planning director. You okay with that, Rob?
Fine.
The tree that is to the left side of your property, left of the driveway, is that going to be removed? Or?
Yes. It has to be. That's the only thing that has to be removed.
I think putting it in the front yard would be kind of odd.
Well, I agree. I was just asking that question. Right. I was just asking that question because it was brought up by the attorney earlier. I don't think that would be a good idea from a planning perspective, given the other homes in the neighborhood and it conforming to those homes. I just brought it up solely for the reason that the attorney for the neighbor brought that up. And the answer for the other question that I can answer for the attorney is, with the wiring and everything else, obviously they have to call before they dig and they have to get all the utilities marked and everything else before anything's done. And Rob, you want to explain that at all?
As far as the utilities? And,
yes.
Carrie's probably better.
Carrie?
Equipped. The contractor that you hire will have to obtain a permit from the city and they would have to be registered. And the contractor, it's the contractor's responsibility to call OOPS before they start digging in any area. They should be aware of that if it's a professional contractor, and they would, the OOPS would come locate the utilities. So there shouldn't be any impact.
Yeah, that's all part of the permit building process. Yeah, that's always handled in the building permit process. So.
And I could answer a couple of the other questions in the letter for the that the attorney provided too, if you want me to. The question of, could overnight parking, a variance for overnight parking, be allowed in front of 7112? I don't believe we've ever done that for anyone on a city street. All the city streets have time period where you cannot park in front of a house. The removal of the sidewalk also would not be, we've never done that before for any type of driveway variance or any type of application like this. if, as a last paragraph of your letter on page two, if none of these alternatives are realistic, perhaps the owners of 7112 could have additional conditions in order to grant the variance, the adding the foliage, he's agreed to that, and landscaping, the drainage to prevent runoff, I believe he just agreed to that. And I think that's what we typically would do in any like situation to help protect the neighbors in a situation like this.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes.
This subdivision is unique in Solon in that we purposefully set it up with small lots and large common area because of the amount of wetlands and unbuildable property that we found or that the developer found in this area. That's why these houses are on such small lots. And the attorney mentioned that the land to the back of your house, northwest of their house, is vacant, and the reason that is because there is wetlands in the middle of that lot that were to be preserved, so that lot will not be developed. We've also done this, I think I counted 11 times on Navajo Trail since the subdivision was built. We have granted a similar variance and under similar conditions, and with some of the similar objections, the one that was of most interest to me was one where we granted the variance for one homeowner over the objection of his neighbor who came back the next month and asked for the same thing. You know, I understand the issue here. I understand that this subdivision was built tight purposefully, and I don't have any problem with granting this, which has really become a typical variance out here.
Excellent, thank you. Any other comments? No? All right, let's.
Mr. Chairman, that being said, I would move to grant a 20-foot, 5-foot accessory pavement setback variance for 7112 Navajo Trail.
Can I add contingencies to that, Mr. Newberry?
Sure.
I would like to add two contingencies to that, and the first contingency is that you, the applicant, will agree to have appropriate screening as approved by the Planning Department in the way of shrubbery to shield the view from your neighbor next door. Are you agree with that?
Yes.
And the second contingency would be that any and all excess drainage occurring from the installation of this pavement specifically will be addressed by you. Yes?
Yes.
Okay.
Excellent. Thank you.
Acceptable.
Thank you. So we have a motion and we have a second and we have two contingencies with that. And now we would like to vote, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Krause?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes.
Excellent. Congratulations. You passed this body. You need to come in front of City Council on July 2nd. It's 7 o'clock caucus. July 2nd, 7 o'clock caucus. And I'll tell you what they're doing there. You might not have to stay, but they'll let you know exactly what's going on.
Okay. Okay? Great. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good luck.
All right, our next agenda item is a council referral. And this is a request from BNH Enterprises to rezone the former Luzak property into a mixed-use development. I understand that, no, that has to do with me, so I understand. Well, we're going to table this item because we really are just kind of in limbo as to how they are going to proceed and if they're going to proceed through us or through other means. And we don't really need to discuss any of that stuff now. We just want to go ahead and table it. So
move to table.
Second. We have a motion and a second, and we would like to vote, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Krause?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes.
I did talk to Mr. Israel Harris last week, so we have been in touch with each other trying to work through that, so excellent. So our next agenda items are we have minors. I believe we have one minor? Two?
One minor.
Oh, and that's right. Did their architect come? Is that you? Hey. It's not going to be really exciting. Mm-hmm. I just want to.
Wait a minute. Let him go through the presentation first.
Yeah, Mr. Green's here in case I mess up. So I told him he wouldn't have to speak. This is for a Church of the Resurrection, and what they want to do is to modify the parking lot. They have a odd situation here where the parking jogs up, and you have kind of like an angle there. What they want to do is remove the pavement in this area. So they'll be adding green space,
going straight across, and I'll show you the drawing, and making the parking a little more usable, adding handicap parking spaces in the area where you have the ramp here. So there's a net gain in parking, a net gain in green space, and the plan, again, what I was showing you on the map here, again, with the Cannon Road out here, it just shows it straightened up here, not impacting any buffers, not impacting other than adding the green space. They would need to meet engineering requirements, obviously, at the time the permits are issued, but engineering has reviewed this, at least preliminarily.
Did Rob Green do that drawing?
Rob Green did that drawing.
You better double check it. So.
There's seven handicap spots back there, I'm counting, is that right?
I'm sorry?
Seven six. Handicap six. Spots back there? Six?
Six. Yeah, six. One, two, three, four, five, six, yep.
Take my glasses off so I can see it. It looks fine. It looks great. Yeah, more green space, more parking. I mean,
right, and they need to get moving. Obviously, they want to get moving while the good weather's here. So,
yep, looks good.
Okay.
Thank you. Thank you. Made it. All right, that's it for our minors, and that was parking. Comments from the audience. This is the time at the end of the meeting. If there are any comments from the audience regarding any agenda item, they would be more than happy to come up and. Make any comments about any agenda items. I don't see any takers, so we will bring it back up here and we will ask for comments from the commission. We'll start with Mr. Mazur.
First of all, I'd like to make a motion at the advice of council to remove three items from the inactive agenda. Item A, 6465 Swamp Center Road. Item B, 6375 Swamp Center Road. And item C, 6353 Swamp Center Road.
Second.
We have a motion and a second to remove these three agenda from our inactive agenda, to remove them. And we'd like to vote, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Krause?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Mr. Polunas?
Yes.
Comment, please, Mr.
Please.
Chairman. Solon Home Days is coming up July 13th to 15th. And as per usual, the Solon Benevolence Fund will be sponsoring the main raffle for the grand prizes of $5,000 cash from Davis Automotive, $1,000 gift certificate courtesy of Calvetta Brothers, two $500 cash courtesies of Plumbing Source, and two $500 gift cards from the Rusty Bucket. And the tickets are $5 a piece or five for 20. They're also available on the weekends at Chicago Deli, the Rose Restaurant, and the Kitchen 56. So please come and spend your money. And I have not sold the winning tickets, even though I told some of these guys I did.
Thank
That's
you.
That's all, Mr. Chairman. Thank you.
Mr. Newberry?
Darn. no further comment. Thank you.
Councilman Polunas?
Yes. I would like to thank the mayor for last evening. There was a town hall, and it's very informative and had some interesting speakers last night. And I think these town hall meetings, I'll save a little bit of this for the council meeting, but I think these town hall meetings really are educational. And I think that with council, we can probably pitch in some ideas for some new ones for, I think the next one's in October.
Correct.
And then we can pitch in some ideas for some, for next year, for some different ideas.
Absolutely.
For different town hall topics that might be of interest to residents. But I think it's a good start with what we had so far. And I think that we can get some more interest if we do a lot more different topics, too.
Thank you. Excellent. Engineering, Ms. Wells, yeah. Chief?
No comments.
No comments.
No comment.
Before the mayor goes, I'd like to make a couple quick comments here. I guess my parents were in the audience and came to visit me. Hi, Mom and Dad. Dr. Mrs. Eugene Bentley, visiting from D.C. or Plano, depends on where they are at the time. And they brought, so Eugene Bentley the third, I'm the fourth, and Eugene Bentley the fifth is sitting there next to them, too. So that's my son. Hi, son. Thanks for coming, guys. Love you guys. Okay, mayor?
I want to thank the councilman for his comments about last evening's town hall. It was on human trafficking. We had some really good speakers. I want to thank everyone that came. It was a tough night being in the middle of summer, but nonetheless, we plowed through. And our next one will be in October on the opioid crisis. We'll have some very interesting speakers. So, and just lastly, we have 4th of July next week, but we're having fireworks on the 3rd, just so everyone knows. So it's Tuesday evening, Look forward to seeing everyone at dusk at the community park. We do have the Solon Community Band, which they really do a great job, the band. And I know they're performing, I think, around 7 o'clock or 7:15 sometime in the park area. So look forward to celebrating the 4th. It's a wonderful holiday, and we can all share together as a part of a community. So thank you.
Thank you. All right. With that,
make a motion to adjourn.
Second.
And we'd like to vote, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Krause?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes.
All right. Good night.
All right.
Good night, everybody.
Thanks, guys.